Good morning all. In this lecture, I am discussing about some basic relationships between pixels. Here, in this topic, if you are taking the relationships, the basic relationships are neighborhood, adjacency, connectivity, regions and boundaries, distance measures. Okay? These are the basic relationships between pixels. So if you are taking any image, that will be denoted by a function of f of x comma y. Here x comma y are spatial coordinates. Each element f of x comma y at location x comma y is called a pixel. That means each point in the image is considered as a pixel. There exists some basic but important relationships between pixels. Okay, those relationships are neighborhood, adjacency, connectivity, regions and boundaries, and distance measures. Okay, now if you are taking the first one, neighborhood pixel, so if you are taking any pixel, that will be here, any pixel p of x comma y has two vertical and two horizontal neighbors. Okay, those will be given by x plus 1 comma y comma x minus 1 comma y comma x comma y plus 1 comma x comma y minus 1. That is, here if you are considering, take this. This is a pixel x comma y. Okay, horizontally two neighbors, those will be, these are the horizontal neighbors. Vertically two neighbors, these are the vertical neighbors. Okay, this is a pixel x comma y we are considering. Horizontal neighbors means on x axis, that means left and right. Okay, left means, so that coordinates will be x minus 1 comma y. Right means the coordinates will be x plus 1 comma y. And vertically two neighbors. What are they? Top and bottom of the pixel. So the top pixel will be denoted as x comma y plus 1, and the bottom pixel is represented as x comma y minus 1. In that way, if you are taking the pixel x comma y, two horizontal neighbors pixels and two vertical neighbors pixels, those will be represented here. See here. So any pixel p of x comma y has two vertical and two horizontal neighbors given by x plus 1 comma y comma x minus 1 comma y. That means the horizontal neighbors. X comma y plus 1 comma x comma y minus 1. Vertical neighbors. This set of pixels are called the four neighbors of P. And is denoted by N4 of P. So these four neighbors are denoted as N4 of P. Each of them are at a unit distance from P. That means here, if you are taking, so x comma y, here x minus 1 comma y. That means how much distance will be? x minus 1. That means the distance is 1. Here, x plus 1. The distance is 1. Next, in horizontal. That means in x direction. Suppose if you are taking in y direction, y minus 1. So the distance is 1. Y plus 1. The distance is 1. That's why here four neighbors, each of them are at a unit distance from P. Okay. So the next diagonal neighbors. Diagonal neighbors. Those will be The four diagonal labels of P of x comma y are given by x plus 1 comma y plus 1 comma x plus 1 comma y minus 1 comma x minus 1 comma y plus 1 comma x minus 1 comma y minus 1. See here. So this is the pixel x comma y. So here this is x plus 1 comma y. So for this top is x plus 1 comma y plus 1. Okay. X plus 1 comma y plus 1. The bottom pixel will be x plus 1 comma y minus 1. In the vertically. Vertically means the y coordinates will be changed. Horizontally means x coordinates will be changed. In that way we remember. Okay. So vertically, that's why y coordinates will be changed. X coordinates will be same. If you observe these three pixels, x plus 1, x plus 1, x plus 1. Where we observe the changes? Vertically. That means y coordinates. This will be y and down will be bottom. Bottom of that cell, that means bottom of the pixel is y minus 1 and the top of the pixel is y plus 1. Okay, like that. Here also vertically x minus 1, x minus 1, x minus 1. All are same. The change is in y direction. Vertical direction in the sense in y direction. So this is y. So the bottom is y minus 1 and the top is y plus 1. Okay, so if you are taking x minus 1 comma y plus 1, x plus 1 comma y plus 1, x plus 1 comma y minus 1, x minus 1 comma y minus 1. These four coordinates are called diagonal labels. Okay, the four diagonal labels of P of x comma y are given by x plus 1 comma y plus 1, x plus 1 comma y minus 1, x minus 1 comma y plus 1, x minus 1 comma y minus 1. Okay, this set, this diagonal labels is represented as nd of p, nd of p, this d is in suffix. Okay, each of them are at Euclidean distance of 1.414 from p. If you are considering the diagonal elements, these are the diagonal elements. Okay, these are the diagonal elements. If you are considering the distance here, from here to here, that means this is this x comma, suppose if you are taking only two points, this is x comma y, this is x minus 1 comma y plus 1. Okay, if we observe here, the Euclidean distance means root of, suppose if this will be x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, then the Euclidean distance is square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus square root of y2 minus y1 whole square. That means the distance between x whole square plus the distance between y whole square. If we are observing x coordinates, what is the distance here? 1. That means 1 square plus, if you observe the y coordinates, what is the distance? 1. So square root of 1 plus 1, that is square root of 2. So that's why the diagonal elements having the distance 1.414 from the P, from the pixel P. Okay, observe here, totally in this diagram only, the neighbors is represented from, is explained from this diagram only. Okay, this is the pixel x comma y. So this pixel having two horizontal neighbors and two vertical neighbors. Totally these four pixels are called N4 of P. Those will be four neighbors of pixel. And these are having unit distance from the pixel P. Okay, four neighbors, that means four neighbors, N4 of P, having the distance unity from the pixel P of x comma y. Okay, next, if you are taking the diagonal pixel. So here, the diagonal pixels means x minus 1 comma y plus 1, x plus 1 comma y plus 1, and x minus 1 comma y minus 1, x plus 1 comma y minus 1. These are called the diagonal labels. These are having 1.414 distance from the pixel. Because here, the distance is getting as 2 to 2. 2 to 2 means 1.414. That's why each diagonal neighbors are at Euclidean distance of 1.414 from P. This is about the neighboring pixel. Okay, so here the points ND of P and N4 of P. This is diagonal neighbors and this is 4 neighbors are together known as 8 neighbors of the point P. Okay, totally the diagonal neighbors and the 4 neighbors combined. That means if you are applying union operation between these two, then that will become the 8 neighbors of the point P. This will be denoted by N8 of P. That means here totally these 8 pixels will be considered 4 neighbors and 4 diagonals. So all are considered, then that will become 8 neighbors. That means 8 neighbors means totally considering all the pixels in this. Okay, that is the 8 neighbors that will be represented by N8 of P. Okay, some of the points in the N4 and ND and NH may fall outside image when P lies on the border of image. Okay, suppose if P lies on the border of image, that means suppose if you are taking this will be the P. Okay, this will be the P. Then what are the neighbors here? This is one neighbor and left side one neighbor and right side another neighbor. So right side another neighbor means here there is no right side neighbor. You are taking the pixel at the boundary. You are taking the pixel at the boundary. That's why only we are getting one horizontal neighbor only. Okay, so no another horizontal neighbor here. Then this pixel represents the boundary pixel. Okay, some of the points in the N4, ND and NH may fall outside image when P lies on the border of image. Okay, see here, neighbors of a pixel, 4 neighbors. If this is a P pixel and 4 neighbors, this will be x comma y, this will be x minus 1 comma y, this will be x plus 1 comma y. Okay, so here x comma y plus 1, x comma y minus 1. Okay, so here x minus 1 comma y, x minus 1 comma y plus 1, y minus 1 here, x minus 1 comma y plus 1 here. Okay, so here this will be, see here, this will be x comma y minus 1. That's why here x comma y minus 1 here. So this will be x plus 1 comma y plus 1. This will be x plus 1 comma y minus 1. Okay, so these are 4 neighbors and these are 4 diagonal neighbors. Okay, totally by combining all these 4 neighbors and diagonal neighbors, that will be 8 neighbors. Okay, that will be 8 neighbors. So 4 neighbors of a pixel P or its vertical and horizontal neighbors denoted by N4 of P. N8 of 8 neighbors of pixel P are its vertical, horizontal and 4 diagonal neighbors denoted by N8 of P. This is 4 neighbors. This is a representation of 8 neighbors. Okay, so here this pixel is P. N4. N4 represents 4 neighbors. ND. ND represents diagonal neighbors. Okay, totally this becomes 8 neighbors. So by taking union between 4 neighbors and diagonal neighbors, we are getting 8 neighbors. The next one is adjacency. Adjacency. Adjacency means just besides. Okay, general meaning is besides. So here, 2 pixels are connected if they are neighbors and their glare level satisfy some specified criteria of similarity. Gray level satisfy some specified criteria of similarity. Now, if you are taking 2 pixels, those are connected if they are neighbors and the gray levels. Gray levels in a sense, gray levels is taken from 0 to 255. totally 256 gray levels will be there. Okay, so here the pixel gray levels also satisfy some specified criteria of similarity. Then only those pixels are adjacency. Okay, for example, in a binary image, two pixels are connected. In a binary image, two pixels are connected. If they are four neighbors and have same values, okay, and have same value, binary image in the sense that is having only either 0 or 1. That's why here in a binary image, two pixels are connected if they are four neighbors and have same value. And have same value, that is either 0 or 1. In this, let P be set of gray level values used to define adjacency. That means this V is taken between 0 to 255. Okay? Four adjacency. Four adjacency means here two pixels P and Q with values from V are four adjacent if Q is in this set of N4 of P. Okay? Q is also taking in the four neighbors of P. Then those P and Q are called four adjacency. Okay? Those P and Q are called four adjacency. See here. Two pixels P and Q values from V. That means V means taking the gray levels. Okay? P having some gray level and Q having some gray level. Okay? Or four adjacent if Q is in this set N4 of P. That means in Q is also a point, a pixel in four neighbors of P, then those will be called as four adjacency. Then those will be called as four adjacency. Next to eight adjacency. Eight adjacency means here two pixels P and Q with values from B or eight adjacent if Q is in the set N8 of P. Both are same. Just here, if Q is in the four neighbors of P, then that will be four adjacency. If Q is in the set N8 of P, that means eight neighbors of P, then that will be called as eight adjacency. That will be called as eight adjacency. See here, eight adjacency means two pixels P and Q with values from B or eight adjacent if Q is in the set N8 of P, that means eight neighbors of P, then that will be called as eight adjacency. Okay, next to M adjacency. M adjacency means M for mixed. Mixed adjacency here. Two pixels P and Q with values from V or M adjacent if here some of the conditions will be there. Q is in N4 of P. That means Q pixel is in the part of four neighbors of P. And the second condition is Q is in ND of P. That means this Q pixel is also in the diagonal neighbors of P. Diagonal neighbors of P. That means Q is in four neighbors of P and Q is in diagonal neighbors of P. And this set N4 of P intersection N4 of Q is empty. N4 of P intersection N4 of Q is empty. Okay, that means whatever the gray levels is taken in B, whatever the gray levels is taken in B, those will not match here. Okay, that means N4 of P intersection N4 of Q is empty. That means the gray levels are different. Then only those will be four adjacent or eight adjacent. Okay, so here suppose that will be empty. N4 of P intersection N4 of P is Q is empty. Then has no pixels whose values are from V. That means that's why Q is in ND of P. Totally, these are the three conditions in mixed adjacency. So here, if you are observing this, to determine whether the pixels are adjacent in some sense. Suppose here, the pixel is here 2, is there. So adjacent means one is adjacent, and from the here one will be there. So this one is adjacent to this one. Okay, this one is adjacent to this one. Here why we are taking one and two means here V contains the gray levels 1, 2. V contains the gray levels 1, 2. That's why here at the pixel P, the intensity level is 2. Okay, the intensity level is 2. Then the top side having 1, and for this one, the neighbor, home neighbor is having the distance unity here 1. Okay, so let V be the set of gray level. V be the set of gray level values used to define connectivity. Used to define connectivity. Then two pixels P, comma Q that have values from the set P, R. Okay, so here if you are taking two pixels P, comma Q that have values the set P, R. So the set P are having four connected. Whenever if Q is in the set N4 of P, and 8 connected if Q is in the set N8 of P. M connected if Q is in N4 of P and Q is in ND of P, and the set N4 of P intersection N4 of Q is MP. Okay? If we observe these two, adjacency and connectivity, both are some related. Okay? So here B is 8 connected. So if Q is ND of P, so whether we are taking this is Q or this, okay? So if you are taking this here, N4 of P intersection, N4 of Q is empty, and Q is in 4 neighbors or Q is in 8 neighbors of P, okay? So in this way, we are representing the connectivity. Okay, in this way we are representing the connectivity. Next, so if you are taking the difference between adjacency and connectivity, so the red line represents adjacent lines. So these two are adjacent, these two are adjacent, these two are adjacent, and these two are adjacent, like that. This is white line represents M adjacent. That means these two are M adjacent, and these two are M adjacent, and these two are M adjacent. Okay, so this is a difference between adjacency and connectivity. Next, if we are taking pixel P is adjacent to pixel Q if they are connected. If they are connected, if both are P and Q are connected, then pixel P is adjacent to pixel Q. Okay. If you are taking two image subsets S1 and S2 are adjacent, if some pixel in S1 is adjacent to some pixel in S2. So here two image subsets. Here two image subsets will be there. This will be S1 and this will be S2. Both are adjacent if some pixel S1 is adjacent to some pixel in S2. Suppose this S1 having some number of pixels and S2 having some number of pixels here. Suppose here the pixels in S2 and here the pixels in S1. Suppose if any pixel in S1 is here and any pixel in S2 is here, if both are neighbors, then S1 and S2 are said to be adjacent. S1 and S2 are said to be adjacent. So up to now we learn about neighbors, adjacency, and connectivity. Neighborhood, neighbor pixels, and adjacency pixels, and connectivity. Okay. So the next one is paths and path lengths. Paths and path lengths. If you are taking a path from pixel P with coordinates x, y, 2 pixel cube with the coordinates x comma t. That means here 3 pixel having the coordinates x comma y and 2 pixel having the coordinates x comma t. It's a sequence of distinct pixels with the coordinates distinct pixels with the coordinates here x naught comma y naught comma x1 comma y1 comma x2 comma y2 and so on xn comma yn. Okay, here we are taking number of coordinates we'll be taking here. If we need the path from pixel p with the coordinates x comma y to pixel q, so here the p coordinates are x comma y and q coordinates are s comma t here. Okay, so the if you are taking as a sequence of distinct pixels with the coordinates, those will be x naught comma y naught comma x1 comma y1 comma x2 comma y2 and so on xn comma yn. Here where x naught comma y naught equal to x comma y and xn comma yn equal to s comma t. That means here we are taking some of the two points here. So those two points, this will be x comma y and this will be s comma t. Okay, this will be pixel p coordinates and this will be pixel q coordinates. Pixel q coordinates here where x naught comma y naught equal to x comma y and xn comma yn equal to s comma t. That means here the first coordinates represents the x comma y represents and xn comma yn represents s comma t. Okay, so here x I comma y I is adjacent to x I minus 1 comma y I minus 1. Okay, x I comma y I is taking as a pixel. For that pixel, the adjacent pixel is x I minus 1 comma y I minus 1 here. Here, n is the length of the path. N is the length of the path. Here, we can define 4, 8 and m paths based on type of adjacency used. Based on type of adjacency used. Next, connected components. Connected components. Here, if P and Q are pixels of an image subset S, then P is connected to Q. Then P is connected to Q in S. If there is a path from P to Q consisting entirely of pixel in S. Okay? Consisting entirely of pixels in S. Okay, see here. Once again, I repeat this. If P and Q are pixels of an image subset S. So in subset S, P and Q are two pixels or included in that subset S. Then P is connected to Q because that P and Q pixels are included in that S subset. That's right. P is connected to Q in S. If there is a path from P to Q, consisting entirely of pixel in S, and consisting entirely of pixels in S. Okay. Next, for every pixel P in S, the set of pixels in S that are connected to P is called a connected component of S. Is called a connected component of S. See here, for every pixel P in S, the set of pixels in S that are connected to P, the set of pixels in S that are connected to P is called a connected component of S. Is called a connected component of S because those will be adjacent. That's why. Okay, so the next point is if S has only one connected component, then S is called connected set. S is called connected set. Okay, so here in this connected components, if P and Q are pixels of an image subset S, then P is connected to Q in S. If there is a path from P to Q consisting entirely of pixels in S. Next, for every pixel P in S, the set of pixels in S that are connected to P is called a connected component of S. Connected component of S. Suppose if S has only one connected component, then S is called a connected set. S is called a connected set. Next, regions and boundaries. If you are taking the image and applying quantizing, so here the boundary of the region R is the set of pixels in the region. Okay, here you are taking some what is region and what is boundary here. Okay, the boundary of the region R is the set of pixels in the region that have one or more neighbors that are not in R. That means, suppose if you are taking the boundary here, already discussed we have. Suppose if you are taking this pixel, so if you are taking the neighbors, four neighbors, this P is one neighbor, this ND is one neighbor, this ND is another neighbor. So here no neighbor will be there. That means whenever no neighbor here, then this for this point, this pixel is representing a boundary. Okay, suppose if you are taking this P, then this represents region because this is having all the neighbors. Okay, so by using that we can say which is region and which is boundary. Okay, see here, a subset R of pixels in an image is called a region of the image if R is a connected set. If R is a connected set, that means that is having all the neighbors. Okay, the boundary of the region R is the set of pixels in the region that have one or more neighbors that are not in R. Those will be called as boundary. Okay, so the next one is distance measures. Now given pixels P, Q and Z with the coordinates x comma y, P coordinates are x comma y, Q coordinates are s comma t and Z coordinates are u comma v respectively. Okay, the distance function D has following properties. What are the properties here? Here we are taking three pixels, P that is x comma y, Q that is s comma t, Z that is u comma v. Okay, if you are taking these three pixels to represent the distance, we are having the following properties. The first property is the distance is always a positive value. How to represent positive value? The distance is always greater than or equal zero. Next, the distance of P comma Q is equal to distance of Q comma P. That means whatever the distance between P and Q is same as the distance between Q and P. Okay, between the two pixels, the distance. Suppose P and Q are two pixels, then the distance of P comma Q is equal to the distance of Q comma P. Okay. The next one is P comma Z. That means the distance between P to Z. The distance between P to Z is less than or equal distance of P comma Q plus distance of Q comma Z. Okay, see here, distance between P and Z. Distance between P and Z is equal to distance between P and Q plus distance between Q and Z. Okay, easily we are saying this. So these are the distance measure. In distance measures, we are following these rules. Next, the following are the different distance measures. See here, the first one is Euclidean distance. Euclidean distance. That Euclidean distance is represented as d of p comma q. D represents Euclidean distance. That is equal to the formula is x minus s whole square plus y minus t whole square. X minus s whole square plus y minus t whole square. Here we need the distance between p comma q. That means the coordinates of p are x comma y. The coordinates of q are s comma t. That means what need here? The distance between x comma y comma s comma t, and the coordinates are here x comma y s comma t. We need the distance between those two pixels. For that, so you are taking the Euclidean distance. That will be equal to x minus s whole square plus y minus t whole square whole power half. Half will be there. Okay, here whole power half root of root will be also be considered as whole power half. Okay, so this is the Euclidean distance. This is the Euclidean distance. What is Euclidean distance? Root of 2, that is 1.414. You are having the Euclidean distance as 1.414. The next one is city block distance. City block distance means here x modulus x minus s plus modulus y minus t. Modulus x minus s plus modulus y minus t. Suppose if you are taking here, this will be the pixel. See here. How to get this values means that it's very simple if you understand. Okay, so if we observe this city block distance, in this city block distance, the representation is d4 of p comma q is equal to modulus x minus s plus modulus y minus t. Okay, suppose if you are taking this will be p, that is x comma y 0. Okay, that is x comma y. If this will be q, okay, this will be q, that is s comma t. This is x comma y pixel, that is p pixel. This will be s comma t pixel, that will be q pixel. Okay, so already we know if you are considering these four neighbors, see here, observe here, this is 0 and 1, 1, 1, 1. How to get these ones? These ones are in four neighbors. Already in the neighbors of four, we learn the distance between the pixels from neighbors is unity. Is unity. That's why these four neighbors are represented as one. Four neighbors are represented as one. Okay, so here if you are taking the city block distance, modulus x minus s plus modulus y minus t. Suppose if you are taking this, how to get 2 here? How to get 2 here? Modulus x minus s, that means modulus x minus means what is the distance here? 1 plus modulus y minus t. Y minus t. This is modulus x minus s. This is modulus y minus t. This means this is 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1. That's why this will be 2. That means in city block distance, these elements are 2, 2, 2, 2. If you see here. So this is 0, 0 point. These are. This point is. This is 0, 0. This point is. What is this point? 0, 1. This point is 0 comma minus 1. Okay. This point is minus 1 comma 0. This point is plus 1 comma 0. The distance is 1 between all these neighbors. So based on that, x minus s means just the distance plus 1 plus y minus t means that is also distance 1 plus 1. So totally we are getting 2. That's why d4 of p comma q, that means so here whenever we are taking city block distance in this, that diagonal elements are 1 plus 1, that is 2. That's why the diagonal elements represents 2. The diagonal elements represents 2 here. Okay. So next, here from here 2, here 1, and here 2. From here 2, here horizontally, vertically also 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. This is the city block distance. Next, here. Chessboard distance. What is this chessboard distance? Chessboard distance means yeah, maximum of x minus s comma y minus t. Maximum of x minus s comma y minus t. That means we are taking modulus x minus s, modulus y minus t. Out of these two points, which is maximum, that will be the distance for p comma q. Okay. That's why if we are observing this matrix here, 0, 0 pixel. So the four neighbors are unit distance 1, 1, 1, 1. And here these diagonals also 1. How these diagonal neighbors becomes 1 means, here we are taking maximum of modulus x minus s comma modulus y minus t. If we observe modulus x minus s, that will be 1. Modulus y minus t, that will be 1. So maximum of 1 comma 1. Maximum of 1 comma 1 means we are getting 1. That's why the diagonal elements also represented as 1. The diagonal elements also represents 1. That's why here totally the 8 neighbors are all 1s here. Okay. The total 8 neighbors are 1. Next, yeah, how to get the 2 here means, so here from the 0 to 1, the distance is 1. That's why from this pixel, 2 pixel also 1. That's why 1 plus 1 becomes 2. Like that, the outer region totally is represented with 2. Okay, this is the chessboard distance. In city block distance, we are adding 1 plus 1, 2. That's why we are getting 2 here. In chessboard distance, we are taking maximum of x minus s comma y minus t. That means maximum of 1 comma 1. 1 comma 1 maximum means only one value that will be. So, 1. That's why only we are getting totally 8 neighbors to this pixel P. Okay. If we extend this A, then totally we are getting the pixel value as 2. Okay. So, these are the distance measures. Okay, these are the distance measures. Now, in this class, we learn totally relationships between pixels. In that relationships between pixels, we are having neighborhood, adjacency, connectivity, regions, and boundaries, distance measures. Neighborhood means in this neighborhood, we learn four neighborhood. And four neighbors of P, N4 of P, four diagonal neighbors of P, that is ND of P, and eight neighbors, that is represented as N8 of P. Okay, based on the pixels, we denote that four neighbors, eight neighbors, and diagonal neighbors. Next, if you are taking adjacency, four adjacency, eight adjacency, and M adjacency, 4 adjacency, 8 adjacency, and M adjacency. Okay. Next, we are taking connectivity. Connectivity. So, connectivity is also shortly related with the adjacency. 4 connectivity, 8 connectivity, and M connectivity. Okay. Next, regions and boundaries. If you are taking one pixel, if you are getting all the neighbors of the pixel, then that will become region. Okay, if you are getting only some of the pixels, some of the pixels are outside the image, then that pixel is the boundary of that image. Next, distance measures. In this distance measures, we learn Euclidean distance and a city block distance and a chessboard distance. The third one is chessboard distance. Okay, so here these are the relationships between pixels. Okay, thank you.